not moving your bicycle, how many of you have tried? Can you stand there still? You will fall, right? Certainly you will fall, but because of the wind. Difficult. But why, when bicycle is moving, when bicycle starts moving, to move, you can balance yourself? Because when the bicycle is moved, so now bicycle is not going down, although there's a turning here, because I have initial turn here, I'll explain that. But bicycle is, this is why it's not falling down. It's not like falling down here. It still can make an angle, kind of vertical angle with respect to the ground. You see it? Okay, so can people quickly explain to me why? Because if this thing is hanging right in the middle, there will be no external torque. So when bicycle is turning, this turning, there's going to be angular momentum in which direction? I know it's difficult, so it must be towards me. This direction. So this has angular momentum in that direction. In that direction, but there's no torque. Both your support is here, there's no torque. Here, there's a little torque here, that's why it's kind of globally rotated. Okay. Suppose there's no torque. If you are riding a bicycle like this, there's no torque. So the angular momentum would like to keep in that direction. Keep direction, which means the wheel cannot fall down. Because if the wheel falls down, the angular momentum will change in direction. Okay? So that's why you can keep the vertical bicycle upwards without turning. Okay? So actually, in principle, the faster you're riding, the faster you're riding, the safer you are not going to fall down. That's why riding bicycle is more difficult to compete slower, not compete faster. It's also difficult, but that's a different story, it's your power. But from the balancing point of view, it's easy to balance when bicycle running is very, very fast. Okay? So another thing about bicycle is that suppose I'm riding a bicycle like this. Not right now, I'm moving forward. So what's angular momentum about this axis? Which direction? Towards you, right? So the bicycle would keep that direction. But suppose I want to turn a direction, change a direction when I ride a bicycle. Of course, you have two ways to do it. One is you just turn the handle, which you turn, right? Another way, you can see more professional bicycles is, they do like this. They lean a little bit. Make a turn. How many of you have tried that? You all try that. You can sometimes have off hands and then still make a turning. Just lean a little bit, you can make a turn. Let's see why. Okay, so when at this direction, what direction of angular momentum? Suppose it's running that direction, right? So suppose at this direction, what direction of angular momentum there? It's that direction. So initially, it's this direction. Angular momentum is this direction, right? After turn, it's this direction. So after turn, it's this direction, okay? So change of angular momentum is in which direction? Vector subtraction must be somewhere in this direction, okay? Somewhere in that direction. So we want to need a torque. Change of angular momentum equal to the torque. We want to create a torque go into that direction. Okay? Go into that direction. So now, I want to calculate that. Suppose I lean a little bit. So gravity is this, gravity is here. Okay? Gravity is here, R is here. Can you use your right-hand rule to see where the torque is? Gravity is down, okay? R is from here, suppose this is support, from here to here, right? So R is from here to here, R is that direction, okay? R cross F is going to that direction. So that will make you turn. Okay, try to do this yourself. Just understand why you lean a little bit, you can make your bicycle turning. If you want to turn that way, you have to lean that direction, okay? Okay, that's all angular momentum, all this formula. Okay, another thing I want you to see is that